Thank you. Thank you. Check. Check, check. August 20, 2021, 9:52 PM Indian Standard Time. I'm doing a track for a Magpie Pirates compilation album, which is supposed to be a tribute for Lou Autumn's. Lou Autumn's, according to the Magpie Pirates Discord server, is some bloke who invented the cassette player, or the cassette technology, if I should say. Personally, to me, this feels a little bit like a disrespect to whoever Lou Autumn's was. I had never heard of this person called Lou Autumn's ever before, until it was mentioned on the Discord. I am a kid who grew up and who was born in the 90s, 1991, and I grew up, there was a small part of my childhood where I did listen to cassettes, but then like when I actually started delving deep into music, I was already using CDs or digital media, so I didn't really get to experience a lot of tape players. I remember my parents and the generation before me, even my older cousin, he listened to a lot of music on tape. I probably just got the tail end of it. I do remember listening to some local rock bands, and before that, like in my childhood, like when I wasn't really into music, I must have had some music which I can't really say though it belonged to me. It was more like stuff that was around the house. Maybe I liked it, maybe my parents liked it, someone liked it, so it was there. But I did get just the tail end of it. I do remember having one compilation album of some local rock bands, Nepali, and that is something I listened to. And by then, I guess I was kind of getting into music and learning the guitar a little bit. So I did listen to the very tail end. After that, like it was all CDs. I listened to most of my music on CDs, and I also remember in my childhood I used to have some tapes from Westlife. That was like one of my favorite groups. This was before I got like into music myself, and some Backstreet Boys. Maybe I think I had a tape by A1, a pop group, boy band called A1, and then it was all digital. Like after that, it was all CDs, so I don't really feel like it's very sincere of me to be doing this track. Right now I'm recording on my DAW. I've just recorded two tracks. The first one was a MIDI instrument called Hybrid Keys. So like, I played it on my MIDI keyboard and then added a VST to it called, what is it called again? It's called a DAW cassette by Clevbrand. So it's supposed to be emulating the sounds of a cassette tape, and I can kind of hear it when I turn it on. There's this button called noise, and I've set it to low, but I could have set it to high as well, but that was really drowning out the pianos a little too much. And then there are some other knobs which I just turned, like I don't really know what they do. One is called tape quality, head quality, motor quality, and I just turned them to my tastes, like without really having a good reference to what a tape actually should sound like. And of course I've seen a few videos, tutorials here and there on YouTube. So that is what I did to like artificially emulate a tape. Right now I don't have any access to any tape player, at least not in my surrounding or not in my grasp, nothing that I could easily access. So I'm using this VST. The reason why I think the reason why I decided to eventually do this track was more like I feel it is a part of history, and especially myself being a musician, like the cassette is an important bit of musical history, and a lot of musicians who came before me went through that experience, and it is something that like revolutionized music distribution and the whole experience of music listening. My family never had a vinyl player, but like we definitely had a cassette tape player, so like I guess it was probably more affordable. I think I even had a Walkman in childhood. Yes, I definitely had a Walkman. I remember like going to some kind of picnic or something like that with that, and I had probably Westlife at that time. So what I mean is like the cassette player became and eventually like because of that music itself became a lot more affordable to people, to the general people. I guess that is why like I eventually decided okay, even if I am doing it in a fake way by using VST plugins, I decided okay, I am gonna do a track to whoever Lou Ortons was. So Lou Ortons, like, you've done a good job, mate. Like, good job, old chap. That's what the English say, right? Old chap, good job. Well done, old chap. Rest in peace.
Thank you.